हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू आवर टेक्निकल सेशन ऑफ पेंट। सो इन टुडेज वीडियो वी आर गोना डिस्कस अबाउट द प्रॉब्लम सॉल्विंग फोरम। सो इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस सम प्रॉब्लम्स रिलेटेड टू पेंट्स एंड रिलेटेड टू पेंट शॉप एंड डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ कोटिंग्स। सो वॉट हाउ कैन वी हैंडल दोज प्रॉब्लम्स? सो देर आर सम स्पेसिफिक क्वेश्चंस एंड आंसर्स आर given, so you can ask more questions if you are having in mind. So I selected for today's two questions and I hope that you enjoy the session. So my first question is like, and a lot of people had asked to me this questions, so that's why I selected. So first question is, when the relative humidity in a paint shop exceeds 80%, then how can you apply waterborne inorganic zinc coating so that it curls sufficiently for top coating in a reasonable time? So answer is for the following question. So as it is a bulk shop, we know that, so we can use dehumidifiers to reduce the humidity, and we can lower the relative humidity less than 80%. And if this dehumidifiers is not available in the paint shop, then to improving ventilations, means providing some extra ventilations and to allow evaporation of the solvent and water, so we can use some ventilation system to evaporate the solvent and water, and that way through which we can reduce the humidity, and we can maintain the humidity and curing point for top coat. Then our second question is like, what causes bubbling or cratering for epoxy intermediate coat when applied over epoxy zinc rich primer? So means if you are having a zinc first coat with epoxy zinc rich primer, then you will gonna apply epoxy intermediate coat on first coat, then what is the causes you face bubbling and cratering on the intermediate? So there are some two answers for the following question. First one is like, if efficient overcoating time is there of the zinc rich primer, then it will cause some remnant solvents to force their base and out through the epoxy intermediate. Means it will go through the epoxy intermediate, that would be the cause for bubbling and creating. And you can see this kind of things like creating and bubbling as appearance. Then second answer is there. So first answer, like, you have to give the proper time for the curing of zinc rich primer. Then second answer, like, two zinc rich primers are porous, they are more porous after applied, and the higher the zinc content they are having, so more porous it will be. Means if they are having more zinc content, they will be more porous. So when a sealant or other layers is applied to over a zinc rich primer, so it will try to fill up the spaces of the porosity, we know that, and expelling the air content in those spaces to pass the surface. So if the dynamic of the sealant layer is not to let the bubble out quickly, then the result is that these bubbles will end up entrapped forming surface bubbles. So it means between the zinc porosity there would be some air. So if that air bubbles won't be released by applying the sealant or anything sealer, then it will come through the intermediate coat and it will form some bubbles or later craters as well. So therefore, to avoid this problem, it is important to apply the following layers to a zinc rich primer using the mist coat or full coat techniques. So there is a technique we can follow to reduce this problem, and which consists of applying a very thin layer first, then letting the air form from the porosity to escape forming bubbles. So that will collapse and close the film, and only then applying the full coat according to specs. So first we can apply just a mist or a thin layer to reduce or escape the foaming bubbles and cratering. And after that, you can apply fully a full coat, whatever is your spec. So these are the way you can handle these two problems. So I hope that you would be liking this video, and if you like, please share and subscribe our channel. So thank you guys. In next forum we'll meet again. So for today's it's almost done. Thank you.